What's up everybody, this is Master Ian Gamer. With 2019 coming to a close, I want to take a moment to run through all the major changes, new features, and updates which happened to Overwatch over the past year, and just reflect for a moment on how they've actually impacted the game, and where they've sort of left the community at this point in time. So without further ado, let's dig into my 2019 Overwatch retrospect. To cover all the significant events, updates, and features which took place over this past year, I want to go through all the major categories of changes, and to start, I want to take a look at the new game modes and features which came to the game. First up is a relatively small feature that I think most people never even realized came into existence, and that's the replay system. While it's something that the vast majority of us probably aren't going to get a whole ton of use out of, I know that I've barely touched it since the thing released, it is still just a nice quality of life addition that a lot of people have been asking for quite a long time. Being able to go back through your matches and seeing maybe the mistakes you've made or how you could improve is a very useful tool for improving as a player and just understanding the game and how it works. So this is definitely a beneficial feature they added, but overall one that's fairly minor. Next up is one which I think is far more significant, and that's the workshop. The workshop is an amazing feature that has introduced a ton of more gameplay potential for a ton of different players who might just be bored with the existing arcade modes or even quick play and competitive. Being able to build your own game modes in different settings is an amazing tool for us to get to mess around with, even if it is a bit complicated and ultimately can only really be utilized by people who are willing to invest the time and effort to figure out how the tool actually works. So far, I've had a lot of fun with it. I expect to have a lot more fun with it in the future, and I think it's safe to say that this is a very positive feature that was added in this past year. The final major feature, though, which I want to talk about for 2019, was truly game-changing, and that's roll queue. Now, there was a lot of controversy about whether or not roll queue would actually improve the game, or if the increase in queue times for people like DPS players was going to end up breaking it and ultimately ruining Overwatch. Well, it did get off to a bit of a rocky start, and there certainly have been some issues with queue times, but with the much more recent while you wait feature being added, I think it's safe to say that at this point, roll queue is undeniably an amazing addition to Overwatch. The average quality of any given match has increased tremendously. Having the set rolls of 2 tanks, 2 supports, and 2 damage heroes means that you're always going to get at least a somewhat balanced team. No more 4 insta-locking DPS, no more solo tanking, none of that, which was honestly really detrimental not even that long ago. So without a shadow of a doubt, roll queue is by far the greatest feature we've had added in 2019, and all I can say is that I really kind of wish they had added it sooner. Moving off of game modes and features though, the next main category I want to take a look at is events. Now this is one where things maybe didn't go quite as we were expecting. In 2019, Overwatch turned 3 years old, and with it, we started getting the 4th year of Overwatch events, starting off with Summer Games 2019, which was pretty unanimously disliked. All we got game mode wise was the return of Lucio Ball, except this time not even with a new map. We got 4 new legendary skins, which to be fair were pretty good, but overall I think in 2019 the issue of events being too stale and repetitive has really started to hit in on the community. People are just bored of the same old game modes, the same old events. There's nothing really exciting to look forward to aside from, well, maybe some new skins, and maybe if you enjoy some of the event-exclusive game modes. We did get the new little May Snowball Deathmatch game mode with this year's Winter Wonderland event, which was actually a nice little surprise, but overall the game mode is fairly simple and not really anything that outstanding in terms of new gameplay or being a new game mode. Even looking at the events before Overwatch's 3rd birthday, this year's Archives event, Storm Rising, was ultimately fairly lackluster, being, in my opinion, basically just a less exciting version of Retribution from the year prior. It had the same enemy types, there was a bit of decent story released with it, which I'll be talking about a little later in this video, but overall, the events for 2019 were definitely not one of Overwatch's strong suits. We did, however, see the further introduction of mini-events, which are periodically spaced out between the other main events and content releases. In 2019, we had four mini events, or challenges as Blizzard officially calls them, being the ones for Ana, Baptiste, Bastion, and Mercy. Now, these are decent little events, you get a couple little cosmetics and a good skin out of it, but ultimately, having these periodic spaced out events just isn't really enough to offset the downsides of Overwatch's main events becoming so stale at this point. Even with the main events getting the sort of weekly challenge system implemented to unlock the epic skins, it's just really not enough to bring it up to the initial level of hype and excitement we got from events in the first and second years of the game. So while there are certainly some good elements here, and I think still having the events as they are is better than having no events, this is absolutely something that I think Overwatch needs to focus on improving in the near future. The next major category, though, I want to look at is story. Now, we've actually had some decent story revealed over the course of 2019. As I mentioned with the mini events, each of them implemented some sort of story element in the form of a short story, with the one exception being Bastion's Brick Challenge. Unless we want to assume that LEGO Bastion is somehow canon, personally, I'm totally down for accepting that. But while the short stories, I think, haven't been quite as popular as the comics and certainly not the animated shorts, it is still nice to see that Blizzard is giving us something, especially since these short stories are all set in the current point in time in the Overwatch timeline and are clearly building up to the story we're going to end up seeing in Overwatch 2. And speaking of Overwatch 2, we did get the new animated short Zero Hour, which I think was a smashing success for the most part, as animated shorts basically always are. We did also get a bit more story revealed through Storm Rising and the Archives mission. It was nice getting to see more of Maximilian and sort of the inner goings-ons with Talon, but ultimately this still felt like just basically build-up to whatever we're going to end up getting with Overwatch 2. I'll be talking more about that a bit later in this video, but the next main category I want to look at is new maps. Now this one's going to be pretty quick because there's not a whole lot to say about it. Over the course of 2019, we got two new maps, being Paris and Havana. Now Paris is, well, not the most popular of maps, let's say, but it is still nice to have. I know that not everyone will agree with that, and simply having Paris exist and the knowledge that you might get sent to Paris when you queue into Quick Player Competitive definitely turns off some people. I personally don't hate the map that much, I think it's alright, definitely not one of my favorites, but it's just nice having more gameplay map variety, and the same extends to Havana, which I think is a much more popular map, and is definitely one that I've really enjoyed playing on. Overall, in terms of the aesthetics of both maps, they're both fantastic, as we would expect, but the fact that we only got two new maps this year instead of three like we have previously is a bit concerning. We do know that the absence of new content like this is because Blizzard is building up for Overwatch 2, and while I'm sure that's going to be great once it does finally release, it is kind of disappointing to be stuck in the meantime where we're getting less new content right now just so that we can have a lot more later. So Overwatch did certainly suffer a bit in 2019 from the previously seen major content additions like new maps, in that we only got two instead of the usual three. And that same issue extends to the next category I'm going to talk about, new heroes. Now, like maps, as I said, we only got two new heroes instead of the usual three, which was very, very disappointing. But I have to say, the two new heroes we did get were fantastic. Baptiste and Sigma are possibly some of the best new heroes we've gotten added post-launch. Now, it's always going to be subjective. Not everybody enjoys playing every specific hero, and I don't think it's fair to try to definitively say that they're the best new heroes we've had added, because of course we all know the real best hero is Wrecking Ball, but Baptiste and Sigma are two very solid additions to the hero roster. Baptiste introduces a fantastically fun new way of playing supports, in that he's basically just a DPS hero, and Sigma is, well, Sigma. You just gotta love him. Even if you're not down with his playstyle and in-game mechanics, you have to admit that his lore, and especially origin story video, are fantastic. Blizzard really hit it out of the park with Sigma as a character and the way he's voiced in-game and the story they've built around him. And honestly, I think he's a fantastic hero, and I really, really hope that we see more heroes like Sigma and Baptiste in the future going forward. And speaking of the future, the last major thing we had from 2019 for Overwatch was the announcement for Overwatch 2. Now, it's a bit weird to talk about Overwatch 2 as a sort of reflection of 2019, given that it's a game that hasn't even released yet, and all we've really seen was the announcement and had the gameplay demo, but it's safe to say that Overwatch 2 is quite literally the future of Overwatch, so we really kind of have to talk about it. The announcement of Overwatch 2 unfortunately was somewhat botched in a few different regards. The leaks, of course, heavily devastated the actual reveal of the animated short and the details about the new game, and Blizzard's very confusing, bizarre, yet ultimately kind of genius strategy for marketing the game as a sequel, when in actuality it's basically just an expansion. A free expansion, I'll mention, since tons of people seem to keep forgetting that or never even learn it in the first place. Overwatch 2 is free if you play Overwatch 1, with the exception of the PvE, but I digress. Overwatch 2 is going to be an exciting new addition, which admittedly I'm a little concerned about for a number of reasons, which I won't go super in depth with in this video because there's going to be more videos coming out in the near future where I talk much more about things to come, but in regards to Overwatch 2 in 2019, it was exciting to get it announced. So then, in closing for 2019, overall, I actually have to say that it was a pretty good year. The new features and content we ended up getting were pretty significant, with things like roll queue and the new heroes being, well, frankly amazing, and things that I can't imagine we ever went without. Really, the only disappointment from 2019 was just the amount of content we ended up getting. We only got 2 maps and heroes instead of the usual 3. Events are just lackluster and that they're not bringing enough new to the table. As I said though, this is supposedly because Blizzard is focusing super hard on Overwatch 2, but it is worth noting that while the amount of content we ended up getting over this past year was significantly lackluster compared to years previous, the content we did actually get was really good. And so if you're a fan of quality over quantity, then 2019, I think, was actually a really satisfactory year. However, Blizzard is really gonna have to up the ante if they want to maintain their player base going into 2020, as while what we did get in 2019 is pretty good, they're gonna have to keep building on top of that as they go into Overwatch 2 if they want to maintain the player base and keep the franchise alive. I personally am confident that they'll be able to pull it off, but it's something that we'll just have to wait and see. And with that, thank you all so much for watching my 2019 Overwatch reflections. I'd love to hear your thoughts on the new content, heroes, features, game modes, events, and such which we got in 2019 by leaving a comment down below. I will be making a video in the very near future covering my expectations and hopes for 2020, so be sure to stay tuned to my channel for that coming very soon. Until then, be sure to leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and share it with a friend if you really liked it. Subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and hit up the bell to never miss any of my future Overwatch content. This is Master Ian Gamer signing off, and until next time, have a great day.